Hello. The presentation today will be on hidradenitis superativa, also known as HS. Learning objectives in relation to HS: understanding the pathophysiology, recognizing common symptoms, and learning how to manage a patient. Here's a brief outline of the specific topics we'll be talking about. Common clinical scenario. A 32-year-old man comes to the clinic complaining of painful swollen boils in both of his armpits and his groin. They have recurred countless times, and he remembers first noticing them as a teenager. On examination, you notice painful, swollen, erythematous nodules, scarred skin, and draining sinus tracts in both regions. He has been treated multiple times with incision and drainage and antibiotics with no relief. What are the next steps to take in the management of this patient? Epidemiology. European studies have shown that HS is not a rare disease. In one study of individuals older than 15, the prevalence was estimated to be 1%. Another study looking more specifically at young adults found the prevalence to be 4%. Females are also more likely to be affected than men, with a 3-to-1 female-to-male ratio. The average age of the onset of symptoms is between 20 and 30, with most individuals presenting after puberty but before the age of 40. The average duration of untreated disease is 20 years. HS is rarely fatal, except when it leads to sepsis in an immunocompromised patient, but can be extremely painful and disabling. Using a standard questionnaire, patients with HS had a worse quality of life than those with alopecia or mild to moderate psoriasis. There's usually a long delay in diagnosis, as patients are reluctant to present to a physician, believing wrongly that their symptoms are solely due to poor hygiene. One study showed a median delay of 12 years, during which time the disease inevitably causes more skin changes and scarring. Furthermore, it is oftentimes mistaken for simple infection, treated with a short course of antibiotics or lancing of the lesion. Due to the fact that the course of most flares is approximately 1 week, this may seem to treat the infection, but it does not actually impact recurrence. Anatomy. The unit of anatomy important in HS is the hair follicle, which is the skin organ that produces hair. Attached to the follicle is the sebaceous gland, which produces an oily substance called sebum. Also attached is the apocrine sweat gland. Unlike the eccrine sweat glands, the apocrine gland consists of a long secretory coil that starts in the subcutaneous tissue, spans the dermis, and empties into a duct that drains into the hair follicle. The intimate relationship of these three structures plays an important role in the development of HS. Pathophysiology. The pathophysiology of HS is not well understood. Although initially it was believed to be primarily due to infection of the apocrine glands, now it is thought of as a disease triggered by follicular occlusion. This plugging results in dilation of the duct and secretory stasis. It is unclear whether this allows bacteria to multiply and whose infection contributes to the weakening of the follicular walls. Regardless, the follicle eventually ruptures, which seeds follicular contents, including bacteria, hair, and sebum, to the dermis. An immunologic response is then triggered, which leads to dermal and subcutaneous abscess and granuloma formation. It is believed that chronic repetition of this process over many years leads to scarring and sinus tract formation. Although it is currently unknown where it initially causes the follicular plugging, the etiology is likely multifactorial. Some researchers have pointed to abnormalities in the hair follicle itself, which ties in with the autosomal dominant inheritance pattern seen in our own study. The fact that the onset of symptoms is so closely tied with puberty raises the hypothesis that sex hormones, mainly androgens, are involved. However, since studies have shown that women with HS do not have elevated levels of androgens, do not have signs of androgen access, and that women are more likely than men to get the disease, it is likely that any effect of androgens occurs at the level of the follicle. This may explain why obesity is linked to an increased severity of HS. The increased insulin and insulin-like growth factor have a putative sensitizing effect on follicular androgen receptors. Epidemiological studies have also shown a strong relationship with smoking, although the exact mechanism for why this is so is unclear. Presentation. Symptoms of HS usually begin at puberty. Patients initially complain of tender subcutaneous nodules, either inflamed or non-inflamed. Careful inspection revealed that these nodules are rounded rather than having the pointed, purulent appearance of simple boils. After rupture, the lesions have a purulent, foul-smelling discharge. Patients usually have at least one lesion active at all times, with the average of 2 per month, although individuals may have as few as 1 per year or 30 per month. As the disease progresses, patients will also present with abscesses, rope-like scars, and draining sinus tracts. The presence of giant, multi-headed comedones is also characteristic of this disease. HS most commonly affects the axilla, 72% of cases, inguinal area, perianal region, mammary region, buttocks, pubic area, chest, scalp, and eyelids. Involvement of the perianal region is most often seen in men. Bilateral involvement of these regions is common. Cultures of the chronic lesions in HS are frequently negative. However, if the sample is taken during a flare, a wide range of bacterial organisms, most commonly normal skin flora such as Staph aureus, may be isolated. Management. Diagnosis of HS can be made based on clinical impression, and biopsy is not necessary. Although no specific diagnostic criteria exist, a physical exam that reveals typical lesions, multiple deep-seated nodules, in typical locations, bilateral involvement of either the axilla, groin, or inframammary areas, coupled with a history of relapses and chronicity, clinches the diagnosis. Hurley's clinical staging system grades the severity of HS and can be used to guide management. Stage 1, abscess formation without sinus tracts or scarring. These patients can be managed with drug therapy. Stage 2, recurrent abscesses with tract formation or scarring. For these patients, a drug therapy can be tried, and troublesome lesions that fail to respond can then be excised. Stage 3, diffuse involvement or multiple interconnected tracts and abscesses. These patients are unlikely to benefit from drug therapy alone and would likely also need a wide surgical excision. Most patients, 75%, will present at stage 1, 24% in stage 2, and only 1% in stage 3. Intervention when the disease is at stage 1 is more likely to result in cure. Further management. All patients, regardless of their Hurley stage, should be advised to minimize irritation to the involved areas caused by heat, friction from clothing, perspiration, strong soaps and scrubs, or shaving. If applicable, they should also be encouraged to stop smoking and to reduce their weight. Drug therapy. There is no evidence that long-term antibiotics alter the natural course of HS. They may be useful in cases of heavy colonization in reducing pain and diminishing odor. Unfortunately, once antibiotics are withdrawn, the relapse of inflammation is almost inevitable. Some studies have shown that a short course of antibiotics, started within an hour of symptoms, may help to prevent the progression of a sterile swollen nodule into a purulent abscess. Antibiotics that have been shown to be effective in randomized controlled trials are topical clindamycin or oral tetracycline. For extensive disease, a combination of systemic clindamycin and rifampicin has been shown to cause significant improvement. Hormonal manipulation therapy has risks and is generally reserved for women with extensive disease. However, one study has shown that antiandrogens may be superior to oral antibiotics. In a small study, ethinyl estradiol plus norgestrel was shown to be effective in curing or improving symptoms of HS. Since inflammation is critical to the pathophysiology of the disease, TNF-alpha inhibitors are being investigated as a treatment modality. Subcutaneous adalimumab therapy has shown some promise in a placebo-controlled trial. However, because their chronic use results in significant side effects, such as a risk of infection, heart failure, and malignancy, their clinical use other than that for the treatment of severe disease will likely be limited. Surgical treatment. The most basic surgical intervention is an incision and drainage. Since this provides no long-term benefit, the lesions will most definitely recur. Its main indication is for a tense abscess that is too painful to bear. Concurrent antibiotics also need to be prescribed. Surgical and roofing is a preferred therapy for extensive HS. The goal of this approach is to identify all abscesses, cysts, and sinus tracts, and to remove the roof, curette the contents, and then leave the base intact, allowing it to heal by secondary intention. A thorough intervention involves using a sinus probe to ensure all lesions are explored for tracts that may not readily be visible. Wide excision is primarily reserved for stage 3 disease and is viewed by some as the best hope for curative therapy. It involves completely excising the involved area with a 1 to 2 centimeter margin that is free of disease. Excision also extends all the way to the fascia, or at least to 0.5 centimeters into the subcutaneous tissue, because apocrine glands are deep structures. The defect is closed with either a split thickness skin graft or a local advancement flap. Important differential diagnoses to consider. Follicular pyoderma, such as folliculitis, furuncles, and carbuncles, are infections arising from a hair follicle. They are usually superficial and do not result in the scarring observed in HS. Crohn's disease. The perianal and vulvar lesions of HS may also be seen in Crohn's disease. However, in Crohn's, there are usually also gastrointestinal symptoms as well. Acne. Superficially may resemble HS, however the distribution of acne, which is the face, upper chest, and back, is completely different from the regions where HS is most commonly found. In summary, HS is a chronic inflammatory process that occurs as a result of occlusion of the hair follicles. The diagnosis of HS is made clinically, and patients usually present with multiple bilateral deep-seated nodules in the axilla, groin, or inframammary areas, coupled with a history of symptoms that started after puberty and have been unremitting despite antibiotic therapy or incision and drainage. While stage 1 disease can be managed with medical therapy, stage 2 and stage 3 disease required some sort of surgical intervention.